Solve the system by graphing. Y equals 3x minus 2, and 3x minus 3y equals negative 6. When we have a system of equations, we're looking for that ordered pair, xy, that satisfies both equations. Each one of these equations has infinite solutions. For example, you could plug in 1 for x, and the corresponding y would be 1 in the first equation. However, it would not fit in the second equation. So we're looking for that one point. So when we're graphing each of these, then we will find that the intersection, the point of intersection, that is where the two graphs cross, will be the xy solution. All right, so let's graph that first one. Y equals 3x minus 2. We have a y-intercept of negative 2 and a slope of 3. So up 3, to the right 1, up 3, to the right 1, and you can just keep on with that pattern to graph that equation. So I'll draw this as straight as I can. Put some arrows on either side to show that that line does go on forever. And now I'm going to graph the other equation, 3x minus 3y equals negative 6. Of course, you could plot points, but the easiest way to graph something is to put it into y-intercept form. So we'll solve for y. So let's first subtract 3x from each side. I'll just show that up here, just so you don't have to see me rewriting the equation. And then we get negative 3y equals negative 3x minus 6. Now we want y by itself, so it's in that y-intercept form. So we're going to divide everything by negative 3. And what you'll have left then is y equals positive x plus 2. So we have a y-intercept of 2 for this second equation. I'll put a box around the second equation. And a slope, remember, if you don't see a coefficient, you can remember that it's 1. So a slope of 1. So we go up 1 to the right 1, and up 1 to the right 1, and keep on going in that fashion. So this just cuts right across the crosshairs there. And we see this point of intersection. I'm going to label that with another bright color. This point of intersection. And that intersection happens to be 2, 4. So that will be our solution. That is the xy pair. That is, if you plugged in 2 for x and 4 for y into each of these equations, both of those would be true. And that's how you solve a system by graphing.